Hey you guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Liz. If you're new here, sorry about the Barney playing in the background, but I'm in a time crunch and I want to film this video for you guys. So get done. My channel is focused on a lot of fitness and motherhood style content. So if those are things you're interested in, make sure you subscribe, stick around, click the thumbs up button if you enjoy content like this, and hit the notification bell to be the first to be notified every time I upload a new video. Today we're combining the two topics of my channel, fitness and motherhood, into one topic all about the exercises you should not do while you're pregnant, but I'm also gonna give you some advice on the exercises that you should do while you're pregnant or postpartum. If that's something that you wanna hear about, stick around. To preface this video, the main reason I'm recording this is because I want to help you guys avoid a specific condition that's called diastasis recti. The reason I'm very passionate about this is because I have this condition. I'm 2 years postpartum, and there's lots of things that I did while I was pregnant that I should not have done. Nobody told me. I had no knowledge surrounding this topic, and I don't think a lot of people do know about diastasis recti. My OB didn't tell me. None of the women in my life had any idea what this condition is or how you cause it. But I was already an active individual while I was pregnant, so I continued to exercise, but I did all the wrong things. So I did things like crunches, I did sit-ups, I did bikes, I did Russian twists. Other things that you shouldn't do are planks. I think I did planks too. I don't know if my posture probably wasn't horrible because I have pretty decent posture, but when you're newly postpartum and you're breastfeeding a little baby, it's important to pay attention to your posture and make sure you're sitting up straight. Be conscious of the fact that you need to keep your core engaged to help your abs heal after pregnancy.
Okay, so this is future Liz coming in with some knowledge bombs that I figured you needed, because this girl, Hannah Bauer, has taught me a lot of what I do know about diastasis recti, and she has given me so many amazing practical tools to fix my diastasis recti. And this caption literally needs to be in this video, so I'm just gonna read it. So did you know that anybody can get diastasis recti? Men, children, and women, pregnant or not. It's just commonly found in pregnancy and postpartum women, as the demands of pregnancy make you more susceptible to intra-abdominal pressure. DR is caused by repetitive uncontrolled pressure within your abdomen during exercise, particularly abs, overhead, pulling, and heavy weights, and daily movement, sitting up, laying down, sneezing, etc. The result of this pressure over time weakens the linea alba connective tissues, which hold your rectus abdominis muscles together. If your connective tissue is injured to the point it can't hold your abs together or create functionality within your inner core unit, injury is likely. Hernias, lower back pain, pelvic pain, the mom pooch, and pelvic floor dysfunction are a few of the common symptoms of DR. The key to DR is prevention, knowing how to properly engage your inner core unit to control internal abdominal pressure is key. However, the education and information available to people about DR isn't talked about enough, and many people suffer trying to heal their DR. It's quite frustrating, actually, as this should be common knowledge taught and available to everyone. Preach. So how do you heal it? In most cases, repatterning how you breathe, move in daily functions, and exercise will either close the separation or make your DR functional. The function of your core unit and ability to provide support and control of intra-abdominal pressure is more important than closing or the width slash depth of the separation itself. This takes a lot of time, awareness, patience, and consistency. Connective tissue takes time to heal due to lack of blood flow, and takes time to truly learn about your core for your body and how to properly engage it.
So with my personal experience, I have been diagnosed with diastasis recti. It's a separation of the ab wall. I was experiencing some back pain. I felt like I had a hernia. My core, I could tell it was pathetically weak. I just had this mummy pooch, like this mummy tummy. I still do have a little bit, but I've used these exercises I'll tell you about to improve it significantly. So I had this pain, I had this protruding belly because my organs were literally pressing on a very, very weak abdominal wall. Not to mention, I had a very strict diet and a strict exercise regimen. So I was working out, I was in the best shape of my entire life. I was thin because I was breastfeeding, so I was like super lean and toned, and I love lifting weights, so I looked good. but I didn't feel good about my stomach and I could tell that I just had a dysfunctional core. So I went to the doctor, she diagnosed me and sent me to a surgeon. The surgeon said the only way to fix it is surgery. And I just think that's absolutely insane. I think if he had any idea about the condition and really had knowledge on it, he would have told me to go to a pelvic floor specialist because they specialize in core rehabilitation after pregnancy. They won't just tell you to do your Kegels because Kegels are not enough, believe it or not. They're part of it, but just not enough. So a few other exercises you should not be doing are things like leg lifts. Mountain climbers are risky because it's hard to keep proper core engagement, and when you're pregnant, you don't want to be doing mountain climbers at all. And when I was newly postpartum, I had just started doing deadlifts and, well, I had always been squatting, but I was new to lifting heavier and getting my progressive overload with weightlifting and just adding more and more weight basically. And I was really excited to go crazy with that on my deadlifts and to really see what I could do in the gym, but I didn't have proper core engagement because I hadn't trained my abs to engage yet. I hadn't retrained them how to connect and have mind to muscle connection. They were so weak, I could barely even feel my abs like below my belly button. So, and I still have trouble connecting with those, but these exercises that I'm gonna tell you about next will help you get back in touch with your core and your deep core muscles.
So all these exercises are safe for pregnancy and postpartum. All of these exercises are going to focus on getting in touch with your deep core muscles and really just learning how to regulate your intra-abdominal pressure, which is the culprit of diastasis recti. With this first exercise, you can tell I'm adjusting my posture, showing you how you should have a neutral spine. You don't want to twist your hips under or push them too far forward, just a neutral spine. Imagine a zipper coming from the bottom of your tummy, just below your belly button, coming all the way up, or maybe a string pulling from the top of your head all the way into your diaphragm, and focus on pulling in your pelvic floor. And you can even do a Kegel during this, and that might help as well. This position on my hands and my knees is one of my favorites, and I pull my heels in towards my butt. And this one lying on the floor, I find that if I put my legs outwards, that it helps me get in touch with my core below my belly button, because that's my biggest trouble area personally. I do this in bed, like when I'm putting Rosalie down for the night or for a nap. You can also try this exercise in a bridge. I'll show you a different variation of that soon that you'll also love. These are called heel sliders. I find that if I take my shoes off, it's a lot easier. But make sure you're controlling your pressure in your abdomen and really, really pulling your belly button in towards your spine, focusing on your TVA, which is your transverse abdominis, which wraps all the way around your back. And it's really important that you're squeezing with all of your might to make sure you're engaging that core and the TVA. So this next variation, I am putting my feet elevated on a chair, and I put a little ball in between my knees and squeeze that ball, squeeze all the ab muscles I can muster, pulling my belly button in towards my spine, my diaphragm up towards my chest. And with these exercises, it's, like I said, not so much about the exercise itself, but focusing on your breathing and learning how to regulate your intra-abdominal pressure. This one is not super effective for me, but I've seen a lot of people have success with it. So you make sure you tense your abs, flex basically as hard as you can, and then you'll twist from side to side, really trying to get in touch with those deep core muscles and your transverse abdominis. This is a side plank, and I personally have found that this helps me a lot. Like I said, regular planks are a no-no. These might be considered more advanced. Just make sure you're really, really squeezing your lower abs.
No swaying, coning, or bulging of the abs. Hold them tight like a lock.
Oh, and also, when I was pregnant, I thought it was super cool that I could sit up out of bed like a normal person, like basically like you're doing a sit-up. The truth is, you shouldn't be prideful and sit up like I did and just think you're super cool because you can do that even though you're 9 months pregnant because you have these strong abs. You're actually damaging your abs and you're separating your ab gap further, and it's gonna make it harder to get that back together when you are postpartum. So my tip to you is to get up like a pregnant woman, okay? So roll to your side, push yourself up with your arm. Don't sit up like I did, and because it'll cause a coning in your belly. You'll kind of be able to see coning or an awkward bulging. Your abs can't properly contract when you're pregnant. If you think about it, it really does make sense. All the research I've done, it so makes sense, and I just know I did everything wrong when I was pregnant. So with most of the tension holds, you'll want to practice and figure out what's gonna work best for you. This has taken me time to figure out what helps my core the most. It sounds like, oh, that's not gonna do anything, but trust me, it will, and it might take a little bit of time for it to feel like it's doing anything, especially if you have a hard time getting in touch with those deep core muscles. You're gonna hold tension as long as you can, flex as hard as you can. Imagine that zipper or string pulling at the top of your abs, and you can hold it for like 30 seconds. I like to set my phone for a 5-minute timer. I'll do 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off, and I'll just repeat that until my timer goes off. And that's kind of what I do every day. Oh, also, if you're gonna do push-ups, you can do push-ups, but you're gonna wanna do hands and knees push-ups. They actually do put a lot of intra-abdominal pressure on your abs, which can, without proper core engagement, that can really widen your ab gap more. So if you feel like you need extra help other than this video, I have found some incredible resources on Instagram, believe it or not. There are some amazing mamas who have really taught me a lot. I will definitely link them all down in the description below so you can also learn from their knowledge and get more tips on how to avoid getting diastasis recti or how to heal your diastasis recti if you already have it. I don't want you guys to be super scared of exercising while you're pregnant. If you're already a super active individual, I highly suggest staying active. But also, you probably should just stop doing abs. Like, just don't do abs. It doesn't make sense to do abs while you're pregnant. Maybe other people already know this, and I was just a fool. I was a fool. But I would just suggest totally getting rid of abs, except for the exercises I showed you, the tension holds, the belly pumps, just things that help you get in touch with your deep core muscles, like the core breathing. All right, that's it for today's video. If you found this content useful, please leave a comment down below. Let me know what else you want to see from me. I do plan to make more videos on this topic because I'm very passionate about it, as you could tell. So if you want that, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're new so you don't miss any of my content. I try to upload 2 videos a week. I'm planning my wedding right now, so things are a little bit hectic, but I'll do my absolute best to get content out for you guys. As always, helping you become your most healthy and thriving selves, giving you practical tools to live your most healthy and thriving lives. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and I love you guys. We'll see you very soon. Bye.